Yes, yes, yes. My ramblings from the Philippines here. The Philippines has 7,641 islands. And after coming over from South Korea, I spent most of my time scuba diving the amazing coastal waters and jumping around in the abundant waterfalls that litter the central Visayas. But the problem I'm going to talk about here isn't with the waters, but with the forests here instead. Between the 1930s and the end of the 80s in the Philippines, they lost around 10 million hectares of forest through legal and illegal logging. And during Marcos's regime for the last 20 years of this, they were losing around 100,000 hectares of forest every year, with there now just being 28% forest cover left. This means that the ecosystem services that the forest provides aren't enough to be sustainable for the population of 110 million people that live across all of these islands. And the forest is integral for providing the ecosystem services such as fresh water and clean air that we all need and therefore deserves our immediate attention. Forests are also a critical habitat for biodiversity, and its loss has been tragic for so many species, including two flagship ones, the Dulongan hornbill and the Philippine eagle, the latter of which only numbers around 500 birds now. With scientists suggesting that 28% forest cover, which is 7 million hectares, isn't enough to be sustainable, and that 12 million hectares is roughly the right amount, it seems like there's a lot of replanting that needs to be done here. I went over to Manila to see the Haribon Foundation, whose name sort of originates from Haring Ibon, the Philippine eagle, which is a real barometer of ecosystem health, and spoke to a forester there who's leading the charge for the 12 million hectare target. Haribon sort of are trying to link biodiversity conservation to just everyday life, and I feel this is really the way to do it. Because biodiversity conservation, to protect the species, you need to protect the ecosystem, e.g. a forest. And a forest, as I said before, provides those critical ecosystem services which are so important to us. Haribon believe that because of this link, everyone can be transformed into a biodiversity champion. These guys act as intermediaries between the government and the community. The government, who give them permission to revitalise the land in the public domain, of which 90% is owned by the state, 20% is a protected area, and 50% that is managed by the community. And on the other end of the spectrum, the community, the ones that live next to this resource every day and therefore should be an integral part of the management process. The communities are brought on side by Haribon, who provide them with money as a community to prepare the land for planting and also as part of the constant ongoing maintenance process of weeding and sort of replanting and resorting out any of the dead plants. And these guys are supported by the forest guards, whose job there is to enforce the moratorium on logging from any illegal activities, which the government is confident is helping to crack down on the sort of illegal logging hotspots around the country. Trees are planted by teams of eager volunteers, of which there have been around 3,000 of so far, and have planted around 1 million trees. This is some going, but has only sort of covered around 700 hectares. Their target is 1 million hectares, one-fifth of the total amount which is needed, and in order to sort of fulfill this, 1.5 billion trees will need to be planted so nature's contribution to people can be felt by all. I asked the forester, alongside all the amazing work they're doing, what else needs to be done? And at the moment they're working on the Forest Resources Bill, a law which makes it an obligation to protect the forest and reach that required amount of trees that we need to provide all the ecosystem services. And this could be revolutionary in mobilising people to help. Alongside laws and regulations, I feel it's imperative to sort of empower people to act on their own accord. And Haribon, alongside education initiatives, are hoping to partner with and educate priests in order to make the most of their existing extensive organisational network of the church. This allows you to reach people you may never have been able to before. The optimism and excitement in the Haribon camp makes the goal palpable, and their onus of linking biodiversity conservation with everyday life is something that I really believe in, and being able to approach people in their own church is really promising towards inspiring others to take action. I think this is something everyone can do in their everyday lives, sort of introducing and normalising actions where they may not have been norms before, slowly changing the ideas and perspectives of those around us, especially when our own well-being is at stake. Ramblings out.